All right, here we go. Polish LAVVU versus USGI pup tent. Horns locked, in battle, let's do it. It's time for the Bushcraft Bivouac Battle Royale, the surplus shelter showdown between USGS pup tent and the Polish LAVVU. Let's do it. Do you like proven outdoor skills, bomber gear, and making your own kit? If you do, join me by subscribing and ringing that bear bell so you don't miss a thing. I'm Dave the Norseman, and on my channel, we do everything because specialization is for insects. Now stick around as the US and Europe lock horns in an apples to apples comparison and battle for who has the best surplus shelter. Now the basic designs of these two shelters are both timeless. They've been around forever and then adopted for military service. The Polish LAVVU was adopted from the LAVVU shelters erected on the go as a portable home for the Samis herding reindeer through Scandinavia. USGS pup tent was adapted from the same pattern and style of tent that we've been using since the American Revolutionary War. And probably we brought them over with us from Europe, and they've been used for many, many years before that. Do you own either or both of these shelters? If you do, put it down in the comments. What do you think? Who do you think is going to be the winner? So historically, both of these shelters are time-proven designs used throughout history by nomadic peoples and armies. But how do the surplus military versions shape up? Round one. First category is price. How does the USGI pup tent shape up? I've found it available online anywhere from $150 all the way down to $35 for the complete set. And an average across the board is probably in the neighborhood of about $65. I got notes. The LAVVU I've seen as high as $140 for the complete set and as low as $65, with an average of anywhere from $90 to $100 for the complete set. Next category is availability. For the US tent, you can find them at almost any surplus store in varying conditions, but you can usually pour through a stack and get two of them that you like and get two complete kits for a fair price with no shipping or anything at the US surplus stores. I have never found a LAVVU at a US surplus store, although I've looked a lot. I've never seen anybody that actually carries them because it's not a US issue item. And I would suspect that that exact same scenario is reversed if you are in Europe. So again, that really depends on your location as to the availability of it. Although both are available online with accompanying shipping costs. Weight. This is a big one. This is a big factor if you plan on hiking this in. But in my case, I don't generally use this as a, I'm not gonna go hiking 20 miles into the mountains with this tent. The only time I'm bringing this tent is if I'm getting most of the way there on my four-wheeler or with a car or a truck, or if I just wanna go out and do a little primitive camp, but I don't have to put a lot of miles on my boots to do it. Although I have hiked the USGS tent in excess of 40 miles while I was serving in the military and that tent was still issued, I would not wanna do it today, and certainly not for fun. So a quick note on it, what I've done with both my kits, because I've had them a while, is I replaced the pins. I don't have the original pins in either one. They have the exact same ones, which are little aluminum Walmart pins. So they both have the correct pin count, but they're not the correct issue pins. They both have the issue poles. And they also both have a very light leather retained strap. But both straps are identical. So the weights may vary slightly, but not very much. So one half of each of these packages is issued to every service member. So they can essentially team up with anyone and build a shelter between the two of them. But it required, both sides require all of these components in order to build a complete shelter. The USGI comes in at 9.8 pounds, so almost 10 pounds, just for the shelter with the components to erect it. The LAVVU comes in at 7.2 pounds, it's not a whole lot lighter. And that's with all the components it takes to erect a full two-person shelter. With a difference of 2.6 pounds, I would say LAVVU is a clear winner on that round. And it's also a slightly smaller package when you bundle it up if you got to hike it in. All right, time for round two. We have three more bouts in round two. But first, put it down in the comments. Would you consider camping in a canvas shelter and carrying it out to the woods? And this is the basic setup of both shelter halves with all the SL3 issue gear and components that go with it. It's a pretty substantial shelter. I spent many, many days of my youth in one of these when I was a young Marine. I'm very comfortable with the setup of it. Hey guys, if you want to see a right, tight, quick, easy way one person can set up this USGI pup tent, follow that link right there. Let's talk about space. I think that this is a great setup for two guys with gear, or it's even more than ample for me, my gear, and my dog. I think it has Well, I'm not going to get all nerdy about square footage. It definitely has more space than the LAVVU, and with my height, I'm not that tall. I'm about 5'10", 5'11", and I can stretch out in here pretty good, but then I have a history of doing that, so I'm kind of comfortable with this shelter over the LAVVU. So SL3 complete without making any components or parts or trying to improvise anything. It's a pretty simple shelter to set up with one man. It doesn't take long. I think give or take 10 minutes, depending on the ground and the surface and what kind of ground prep you have to do and how much experience you have actually setting the thing up. So I think give or take 10 minutes is probably a fair estimate on both of these. I think they're pretty equal. I'm a little slower on the LAVVU setup, but that's because I don't have as much experience with it as I have in this one. Now, one advantage that the USGI shelter half has over the LAVVU is actually connecting the two together. With the USGI, you just line up the double rows of snaps and snap all the way down the ridgeline and you're pretty much set up. And all you have to do is ensure that you have the open edge of the flap on the leeward side of your shelter. This is a really durable tent. The canvas is heavy duty. This one was made in the 70s. I think this one was made about 75. And then the LAVVU, on the same note, was made, I have one that's from 75 and one from 76. So they're right in the same era. The canvas is heavier than the canvas on the LAVVU, and all the seams are stitched up really good and solid, but you know, they're a little sloppy, it's government surplus. But they're really, really sturdy, they hold up really well in high winds, they hold up fine in rain and in other weather conditions. It's just a really, really good option for a one-man tent if you're willing to deal with and bear the weight, because they're not light, you know. Now this has a lot less potential for leaking from the rain because it only has the seam on the roof, and if you make sure that this button seam right here is on the leeward side, then when the rain comes in and the wind and everything, there's no place for it to enter on the other side of the tent. Same thing goes with your door flaps, and you can orient them whichever way you want to according to the prevailing winds and use that as part of your waterproofing method as well. It's also very easy without running a guy line, it's really easy to just stretch a poncho or a tarp over the top of this and then stake it out a little wider on the outside, and then you get a little bit more of a tapered roof that can protect this canvas from the rain. I think it's a lot easier to use a canvas fly or a military issue poncho to waterproof this than it is to waterproof the LAVVU. As far as ventilation goes, if you put it out in the bright sun, it's gonna get hot. This dark green absorbs that heat and it gets piping hot inside there. But I've got one door panel open. You can open the other door panel and then you can do the same thing on the backside. Basically just have this A-frame that's open on both ends for ventilation. And then you only need to really button it up unless if you need to button it up to get out of the elements or if you need to seal it up for some reason. So it's really good for ventilation. It really has a good pass through of airflow when it needs it. And lastly, all the components are super sturdy, military issue, military grade. Of course, I've replaced all my pins with just lighter ones, but you can make those on the fly pretty quick anyway. Parts are readily available. You can pretty much go into any surplus store and pick up the poles. But like I said, they're easy enough to replace. I don't have the measurement of the pole, but I know that if I'm standing on flat grounds, two fingers above my belly button, that's the height of the pole for me. So if I need to cut a pole in nature, I already have a body measurement that I can go off of, and I know that I can cut that pole, so I don't need any other measurements other than my height and a small tree. Hey guys, one more thing. I put links to these, both of these, down in the description. The LAVVU is an Amazon link, and then I did a LAVVU overnighter a while back, my first overnighter in that LAVVU, and I had a bunch of cool gear with me, and I put links to all of that down there too. They're all Amazon affiliate links. I do get a little kickback from Amazon, but it doesn't cost you anything else. So if you're thinking about that gear anyway, or you saw something that you might've caught your eye, that's where you get it. Also, all the leather gear, you know, I'll have a lot of really cool leather gear here and there. And most of that is produced by my wife. I build a little bit of it, but she does most of it. So most of that is also available like in custom form or fashion through my website, which is also linked below. So I hope to hear from you. So now let's talk about this LAVVU. Again, military issue. The stitching is bomber. It's really solid. I don't think you'll ever have any issues with that. Now, buttoning the LAVVU together is a little bit more complicated of a setup. It's kind of a double button thing. You have to go through the whole thing and button it once, and then go through the whole thing again and button the rain flaps, and then ensure that the armholes are also buttoned closed. So there's a little bit more technicality to it, but I think that when you get used to doing it and you kind of break the buttonholes in a little bit, it'll go by pretty quick. Again, it's super dark. It's essentially the same color canvas. I think this canvas is a little lighter than the canvas on the USGS tent. Not sure that's gonna make a difference, though. I think, being that it's also an article of clothing, that they've actually put a tighter weave canvas on it so they could go with a slightly lighter canvas. I like the one pull setup. I don't have a body measurement for it, but I did mark on my door flap a height measurement. So when I lay this out in the forest, I can just drop a tree and cut my measurement for the center pole so I don't have to bring those pole sections, or if I lose them or if they break. I think it's interesting that this LAVVU, when you set it up as a tent, it's inside out from when you wear it as a poncho. With the poncho, it had the flap to double up on the shoulders. That flap is on the inside now because of the orientation of the armholes and the way those flaps button up. I also think that those armholes might have a little bit more possibility of allowing leaks to come in through those holes just because of the angle that they are on the outsides of the LAVVU. I think water would have a tendency to actually run into those holes and drip on the inside of the LAVVU. As far as space, it's interesting. It's kind of like a teepee where you have some space around the edges that's unusable for the most part because it tapers down to the ground. It's not that big a deal though, because usually the unused space is where I would put some firewood, I would put some gear, I would maybe stuff in other little things that I want access to around the inside. So I don't see a problem with that. But I think that the size of this is much better suited to one man, or one man, dog, and gear, as opposed to two people, unless they're not huge people. I think me and my wife could probably be comfortable in here, but when we start loading in gear and bringing in the dogs and everything, I think that we'd have to actually set up another sort of a shelter system. So I think this is perfect, ideal for a one-person shelter. I think it's really comfortable. The advantage to this is you can actually sit upright in it, and you can't do that in the pup tent. I think the pup tent is more comfortable to lay out in than this, but if you're actually gonna hang out in it in inclement weather or in the snow or whatever, if you're gonna actually hang out inside the tent, I think this is the one to have. If you're just gonna go in there to sleep and lay down and then be out in the nature the rest of the day, then I think the pup tent might be a good way to go as well. As far as durability goes, of course, it's military surplus, and they build things to last in the military. I wouldn't see any problems with anything. One of the only problems I could see is that maybe a button would pop off, in which case you can just sew it back on. Whereas with the military pup tent, if a snap breaks or pops off, you're not fixing it until you get back and get the materials together to actually do a snap repair. So I think that on field repair, this one might have a slight advantage over the pup tent. And due to the construction and the way that this goes together, the way that the two ponchos overlap on the top, you can actually unhook one and open it up, which creates a ventilation for the top. So if you're actually gonna be using like a small stove, like an ember-lit stove or something inside here to heat coffee or whatnot, then you have that ventilation that you can open up, and all that carbon monoxide and smoke or anything else can go right off the top. That's definitely a plus if you're gonna be using it for any kind of heat. Also, if you're thinking about going between these two for a hot tent, keep in mind that if you use a very small ammo can stove or something, in this tent, you have ventilation at the top, and then you can unbutton the armholes, any one of the four armholes, to run the stove pipe out of, as long as you put some kind of an insulator in there. You don't have to make any modifications to it. Whereas if you decide to use the USGI pup tent, you're gonna have to make some level of modification to one of the pieces of canvas for a stove pipe to go out. So in that, I think the LAVVU also has a slight advantage. Now, as you can see here, with a little extra line and the proper application of some specialty knots, you don't even need poles to set this one up. Of course, not ever willing to be outdone by the US, the LAVVU pulls through with a no pole ridgeline setup, just like the pup tent. Now the USGI pup tent makes a wonderful bomber one person lean-to if you don't have both kits. But be advised, if you don't have both kits, you're gonna have to improvise or bring with you one more pole section. A trekking pole makes a really great option, and you can even eliminate that one and bring two trekking poles and not even have to bring the heavy issued poles at all. You'll have to improvise one more guy line, and you'll need two tent stakes. Now, most of this stuff can be improvised in the field with no problem. Just thought it was worth mentioning that one half of the shelter is not complete without a little bit of extra work or bringing a little bit of extra gear from another half. Now, when using the LAVVU as an open one-man shelter, it's perfectly suited for that. You will always have to improvise this pole. You can use your hiking stick, but make sure that the ones you bring are long enough to do the job, because mine is maxed out when it's high enough to work as a LAVVU pole. But I always find it's easier to just improvise this one from nature. There is no chance that the pole that came with it is worth anything in a setup like this, unless you bring an extra set of poles. You will also have to improvise a guy line, which normally the LAVVU doesn't require any guy lines, but you're gonna need one to keep the pole erect. And you will also need to improvise two pins, one here and one for the corner, which would normally be a shared pin when you button it together with the other LAVVU. So two pins, one guideline, and the pole. So it's really pretty much on par with the USGS tent when it comes to improvising pieces and parts to use it as a one-man show. All right, going into round three, which of these two are you leaning towards now after seeing the information so far? Put it down there, let me know. Now let's talk about other uses outside of just being a double or a single shelter. The shelter half doesn't really have any. I have certainly curled up in it on a cold, rainy night inside of a hide when we didn't have any room to set up a shelter, but I had one with me. I've also used it to bundle up gear and package it up really tight, manning up with the guy line. And it does okay for that as well, if you really gotta pack it up tight and haul it out. Other uses I've used as a sleeping bag cover, rolling the ends together, snapping them together, pull the feet flap in, and then lay in it as a sleeping bag. They work great for that. But overall, it doesn't actually have any other design purposes to it. I think that's where the LAVVU might actually beat it, because it'll do all of that and then a little more. Now the LAVVU actually has the built-in design feature to be used as a rain poncho or just another warming layer. I don't know how waterproof it would actually be, but it does have double flaps on the shoulders to help keep your shoulders a little bit more dry in the rain. That is definitely an advantage that the piece of gear itself has more than one purpose as a wearable shelter. Now both shelters have perfect interoperability with every other issued shelter. With the USGS, the pre-Vietnam era, instead of having these snaps, they had buttons. And so if you're buying a USGS, you want to double check and make sure that they both have snaps or they both have buttons. If you're buying it online, then it's probably worth it to contact the seller and make sure. The ones with the buttons are getting harder and harder to find, but you may accidentally get one when buying a pair. And if you accidentally get one, the two are not compatible with each other. With the LAVVU, there are three different patterns available. They're all interoperable. They'll button together and they'll work the same, but there's essentially a size 1, a size 2. You can tell by the two grommets. A size 1 will have one grommet, and a size 3 will have three grommets. And essentially, those sizes are based on the height of the user when wearing it as a poncho. But you can still hook together a size 1 with a size 3. You'll just have a little bit more flap sticking out on one side on the 3, but they are interoperable. Now, I think if you go online and you research either one of these two shelters, you'll find mixed opinions on both sides of the fence, but I've given you pretty much all the information that you would need to know about either one of these two shelters if you were considering it. There's also a plethora of information on modifications that you can make to them. You can buy another half and add it to this and build like a baker tent or put zipper sides on it so the wall opens up, and people have modified the LAVVU with a front zipper, and they've put raised skirting all the way around it and sewn in a floor. all those kind of things that you can do. I mean, if you're kind of into the whole modification thing, there's plenty of really, really cool ideas out there that people are already doing. So who won? Who takes the gold? Me personally, I think I need to spend a little bit more time in both of them in all four seasons before I can really make that determination, because they seem pretty neck and neck. I think, in my opinion, the LAVVU has a slight advantage right now, even though I'm more comfortable in the pup tent. We'll see how that works out when the season rolls on and I get a little bit more time in both of them. So if you've already made a decision, put it down in the comments. Let us know. Let me know what is the deciding factor for you to pick one over the other. If you enjoyed that or you got anything out of it, don't let it end. Hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you don't miss a thing. Till next time, I'll see you on the trail.